Jerusalem calls to the faithful. Here, the Bible comes to life, and pilgrims come in search of its history.
This is something that is one of the most powerful and remarkable things about the tradition, is that you can actually go to the place where things happened. Mm.
We've come to the Old City with Professor Paula Fredrickson in search of the historical Jesus.
I think the historical Jesus has always mattered to Christianity, or we wouldn't have the Gospels.
Right.
Those are stories about Jesus the man.
Along the Via Dolorosa, the pilgrim imagines the agony and physical strain for Jesus of Nazareth during the march to crucifixion. On his final journey, the Gospels say he faltered carrying the cross, placing his hand on this stone before Simon helps to bear the burden. Visiting Methodists from a church in St. Louis find a visit to the place makes for deeper spiritual meaning.
I think scripture goes from black and white to technicolor when you come here, because all of a sudden you serendipitously discover things, or you've been reading it your whole life, studying your whole life, and it's like this kind of aha, oh my goodness, I get why Jesus came here.
Jerusalem is the epicenter of three great faiths, Christianity, Judaism, and Islam. But more than half of the visitors to the country are Christians, coming increasingly from Asia and African nations. Leading parishioners from Ohio to the site of the Visitation, where Mary is said to have praised God after learning she is the mother of Jesus, Father Steve Bronofsky says the history is meant to help us live our faith today.
When you go to a place where there's a shrine, or where your ancestors have been, where people of faith have been for a long period of time, it also reminds you that, you know, we're all on pilgrimage, and we take this experience of these holy places into our daily life.
The narrative of the New Testament unfolds powerfully along the shores of the Sea of Galilee. Here is where the ministry of Jesus was formed. And today is where religious pilgrims come to explore the natural beauty of this area, but also to look up from the pages of the Gospels and imagine what happened here. This is a landscape of miracles, love, and faith, where Jesus is said to have told his followers, "Don't be afraid." Today, it's where pilgrims come to dig even deeper. These students from Chile are volunteering at an archaeological site in the first century port town of Magdala.
We are trying to replicate and to show the people how they lived in the last 2,000 years.
Artifacts from such digs may end up at the Israel Museum in Jerusalem. Here, the findings include remains of a Jewish high priest and a stone bearing the name of Roman governor Pontius Pilate.
So it's an amazing coincidence that two artifacts like this that relate directly to the last moments of Jesus, to the arrest and trial and crucifixion, were found in excavations.
Evidence for the faithful in this city under God. David Gregory, CNN, Jerusalem.